What's going on? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Isaac Lefler. Thank you for joining us. Today we'll listen to some rap songs by Earl Sweatshirt. I do know a little bit about Earl Sweatshirt. I know that he was part of Odd Future, if I'm not mistaken, with Frank Ocean and Tyler, the Creator. Seen a lot of old clips of them hanging out together. I don't think I have any Earl Sweatshirt songs solo from him in my liked songs or anything. So very excited to see what he has to offer. I'm really going in with no prior knowledge of any of his music, like I just said. So yeah, without further ado, let's get right into it. First track, Shattered Dreams. Here we go.
Imprecise words.
Yeah. See, get it, cause we mean it. These are free smoking niggas need it. Mask off, mask on, we trick
or treating. Kinda reminds me of Griselda.
Back off, stand off and chillin'.
Like a Griselda.
Why nobody tell me I was bleeding? Please, nobody pinch me out this dream. I said peace to my dirty water. Yeah. We win again, see them within. Seen teeth on the floor, leaking again. We hold the door, we build the bridge. We hold the core, send a cease and desist. Till you take the torches and go and get some decent decor. Is you gon' rip it, or will you jump? Get some more ribbons for the born winners from the jump. Niggas don't listen to their whole mission. Was a one's face dripping, Hate swimming through your bloodlines. Motherfucking judge, same going to the one time. Yeah. Come and take a stroll in a mud. But,
imprecise words.
Yeah, she get it cause we mean it. These are free. Blast off buckshot into my ceiling. Why ain't nobody tell me I was bleeding?
This is odd. Okay, Shattered Dreams. I'm not sure how I feel about that one. It was a Griselda-ish, Freddie Gibbs-ish kind of beat to me, where it was like an odd looping sample that you might not expect to hear, but is appealing to the ear. The beat blended very well in with his voice, and I don't know if that aided in me not getting super engaged with what he was saying, but for some reason, like, I just didn't pick up on that many lines. It's like his voice just like another part of the beat, and there wasn't punchy. It didn't stick out very much to me. Like, he was very monotone, and the whole energy as like a whole from the song was just an odd energy. He seems like down, like downtrodden, and also introspective, like an observant. I don't know how to describe it. It was like relaxed, and I don't know, like almost, it felt like people watching. That's what I felt like. So I'm going to read the description from Genius, and maybe that'll help me understand it better. It says, Shattered Dreams is the first song off some rap songs. He introspectively discusses a variety of topics throughout the years between 2016 and 2018. Earl grounds the discussion in what he describes as imprecise words, meaning he feels his words can't do justice to the emotional weight of these experiences, a concept seen throughout the album. Okay, well, I wish I wouldn't have read that, because that kind of just gave me the concept. I like to figure that stuff out by myself, but maybe that'll help me. Maybe it's just like a setup song. We'll see. Go to the next one. Redwater. Here we go.
I know I'm a king, stock on my sea, lying through your teeth, fingers on my soul, this is 23, blood in the water, I'm walking in my sleep, blood on my father, I got a king, stock on my shoulder, I was sinking, I ain't know that I could leave, papa call me chief, gotta get
another
teeth,
odd beat.
Fingers on my
odd
soul, this is 23, blood in the water, I was walking in my sleep. Blood on my father, I got another dream. I was playing with magic, I leave. Papa call me chief, gotta keep brief. Lock and load, I can see you lying through your teeth. Fingers on my soul, this is 23. Blood in the wall, I'm a king. Stock on my shoulder, I was sinking. I ain't know that I could leave. Papa call me chief, gotta keep brief. Lock and load, I'm walking in my sleep. Blood on my father, I got another dream. I was playing with magic, high blessings in my sleeve.
Okay, that was an odd one, because it was just like repeating the same stuff over and over again. Another odd beat, odd flow. But I'm not sure about the production, because it kind of felt the same thing again, where like the beat feels more prominent than his voice, and I'm not loving that. Just the 8 bars he was repeating. Yeah, I know I'm king. Stock on my shoulder, I was sinking. I know that I could leave. Papa called me chief. Gotta keep it brief. Locked and loaded, I can see you lying through your teeth. Fingers on my soul, this is 23. Blood in the water, I was walking in my sleep. Blood on my father, I forgot another dream. I was playing with the magic, hide blessings in my sleep. Okay, I'm gonna use Genius again, because I just feel like I'm not getting it. So, yeah, I know I'm King stuck on my shoulder. Earl implies that he's the stock of his gun is pressed up on his shoulder, possible double entendre versus the stock of an anchor, which is on his shoulder, which would call him to sink. I know I could leave. That one says it's not, it's unreviewed. Gotta keep it brief. Earl discusses the concept of brevity within an interview. Yeah, I don't know about that. And that one was just odd. I don't know. All right, let's go to the next one. Cold Summers. Here we go.
We roam tundras. The boy been gone a few weeks from it. Don't tell me they don't hunt us for sport. I chose substances. No cuddles, the bases all covered. Niggas come in the door and smoke something. Choke up, press up on the boy. No more bluffing. Cold summers don't tussle with strangers. Some of those keep one in the chamber. Three skin and muzzle my brain up. Really, I'm just making sure my promises kept. Chunk of douche ass. See it through. Keep a noose hanging off of my neck. We got the juice. Niggas corny as shit. We on the loose juice. Niggas know what it is. Yeah.
It is night, and like the others, I clean my weapons. It is all so familiar.
Okay, Cold Summer, super short, but I liked it a lot. Felt very MF Doom in the production, and his delivery was much more. It wasn't super energized, but there's definitely more energy than there was on Shattered Dreams and Red Water, which I appreciated. Like I said, the MF Doom kind of beat. And there was a couple lines in there that I really enjoyed, which was this little stretch. Where was it? Dude, it's on chest thump, his head thump on the floor. We pressed up on the boy, no more bluffing. Cold summers don't tussle with strangers. Some of those keep on one in the chamber. Nice little pocket right there. And where was the other one? Three spliffs had my wingtips clipped. I was stuck in a hangar, dude. Muffled my pain and my muzzle my brain up. Really, I'm just making sure my promises kept. Chuck up a deuce. If you know it's the end, kept the truth in my palm and my chest. Another little pocket that I liked a lot. So yeah, Cold Summer, short track, but got my attention. Really enjoyed it. Go to the next one. Nowhere to Go. Here we go.
We back, yeah. Yeah.
Like that one.
I got a watch on step. I keep it quiet as cat. Yeah, I think I spent most of my life in prayer. Only thing on my mind was that didn't know myself. First I had to find it. I couldn't find a friend. Had to rely on my wits. I be with Mike and man. 9 days I be with Sage and with Six.
Prince. I like the
dig. I'm in LA. We go. Toast, bro, you know if you with me, we homebound. I need a city to hold down. You niggas gave me a coast. You went and gave me a cape. But that never gave me no hope. Yeah, feel my soul, but I keep the memories close by. Even when I hit a low, I still give thanks to the most high. I can't do favors no more. If you lame and you broke and you waiting for cosign, I take a play to go. Playing for both sides. This shit can take a toll. There ain't no. There ain't no. Yeah.
Okay, Nowhere to Go. Interesting track. Like the beat a lot. It was a very abstract beat, which I was a little, like, at first I was like, whoa, what's going on? But I actually did enjoy it a lot. There's a couple lines that stuck out to me. Let's see if I can find them. Here it is. Yeah, I think I spent most of my life depressed. Most of my only thing on my mind was death. Didn't know if my time was next. Sounds like Earl's talking about his mental health, dealing with depression and that kind of, or that those kinds of issues and just how it maybe overtook his life and was, it's obviously a big part of his life because he's putting it in his music. So interesting. I like that he feels confident enough to share those intimate parts of his life. And then there was a line where he said, he goes, let's try a different approach out. And then he starts to switch up the flow a little bit. There was another pocket that I liked. Let me see if I can find it. Yeah, it's right here. It goes, I can't do favors no more. If you lame and you broke and you waiting for a cosign, I'll take a plate to go. Bread I could go break with a bro. Noose on the chain was gold. I really enjoyed that little pocket. But yeah, overall, song felt kind of relaxed and just enjoyed the song as a whole, honestly. Nowhere to Go. Solid. Going to the next one. December 24. Here we go.
It is surely time that the speech of black culture in America be recognized as a genuine.
Allen with the pick fro, answer in the outlet. Alley-ooping all this shit home. Powered up, out for the assist, don't panic when it get cold. We go at it, ho. How you want them ribs smoke strip? Don't panic when the pig comes. Scramble, get the big talk, fed it in and get home. Tally up the wins, though.
I lived out the way, hey. Palace where the crypts stay. Silent when the pigs came browsing in this shit. Bang like two mallets, too callous for your bitch taste. Remember when they had my grandmammy on a drip drink? How much of that gin strength could have taken? You die and then you live, huh? Your heart and then your limbs break. Just catch me when I slip, bro. It was popping like a hip bone. I told you, the ashes in the end, bro. We been took you passing your credentials. Bad apple daily clashing with my kinfolk. Badass it did.
I like that beat. A lot of these have been really short, but I'm enjoying it. They're compact and they're getting their message across. This one was more rap, boom, bap. Really enjoyed the beat as a whole. There was a little pocket where he went, tally up the wins, though. I don't think he said he pro-violence, but it's going to be your problem if he did, though. I lived out the way, eh? Really enjoyed that. Also, just like the bar, like, he's not about being a violent person, but if you want to push it there, he can take it there. Enjoyed that. Also, just the delivery he had on this line where he goes, remember when they had my grandmammy on the drip drink? How much that gin straight? Could have filled a fish tank. My doggy hit my sails, said he got me up the strength. That was a nice little pocket. Enjoyed that. And then it was a line that just finished the song, which I thought was very nice. It goes, bad acid did damage to my mental. Show you right, it took some passages to get grown. They called me savage from the get-go. Just like that little pocket there. And the bad acid did damage to my mental. I'm assuming he's talking about probably drugs and LSD, acid, whatever you want to call it. So, yeah. Overall, though, December 24th, solid track. Here's the next one, On the Way, featuring Standing on the Corner. Here we go.
Yo. Do you niggas know? All right, check it out, bro. Look. My mood really swinging. I peruse like a native would do. What I'm thinking I should do for the sake of myself. No games with this cash, go play with yourself. See you shooting, but your angles was trash. Don't play with us, I revisit the past. Pour wine and pages of past. Mama say don't play with them scabs. It's safe to say I saw 12th Street. I kept some lean around. Help me, it's been a minute since I seen a decent count. The wealth be the labor's fruit. The loop pulled up the belt, G's felt. All praises due to Tang in the booth. Dark face on the news, clouds gray. On the move, on the way, like the truth. Yeah.
I said the dark face on the news, clouds gray on the move.
On the Way, interesting track. Don't feel like I caught a whole lot of the lyrics. I was just enjoying the song as a whole when I was listening. I felt like I kind of just took a step back and enjoyed it. Liked the sample a lot, the soul sample. Bringing it back to the production we were talking about earlier, where my complaint, my gripe was you couldn't hear Earl's voice very prominently. That's already transitioned out. That was really just like the first two songs. After that, it's kind of gone back to traditional where it's like, okay, he is the prominent part of the track, which I enjoyed. There still was a couple lines that I did notice. One of them being, don't know what I'm going to say because I don't label the bags. I stay in them. See you shooting, but your angles is trash. Don't play with us. I revisit the past. Like that little bag. Also, like, I don't know what he means by I don't label the bags. Maybe, like, traveling a lot. Like, you have to put, like, labels on your bag. And then, but he's already in his bag. Like, meaning, like, he's in the zone. Also, like, this line where he says, I need you now. Closed lips make a mouth breather's frown. Two's a team, three's a crowd. 12th Street, I keep some lean around. Nice little pocket right there. Also, like, the two's a team, three's a crowd line. I thought that was a little funny. And there was one bar that just caught my attention. I don't know how many of you guys know about Tang. Tang was a drink that I had as a kid. I was always told by my grandparents, oh, this is what the astronauts drink. This is what the astronauts drink. So I just thought that was funny where he says, all praise due. The juice unobtainable like Tang in the booth. Very odd ending, but yeah, didn't overanalyze that song. These are all short, so it's a little bit different because in the past I've said when like long songs are bar heavy, like it's hard for me to register it all. I feel like the same thing's happening here where like I'm just listening casually and trying to enjoy it because it looks like all these songs are pretty short. So I'm not overanalyzing and there's not enough time for me to like try to piece all the things together. Like there isn't like a a 3 to 5 minute song. So this is definitely needing more than one listen. I'm just going to go ahead and put that out there now. But anyways, let's get back into the review. Next song up, The Mint featuring Navy Blue. Never heard of Navy Blue. Heard of the color, not the artist, but here we go.
That's right. I'm running things. I'm running things.
Hold me down. Hold me up. Hold me close, cause when times are up, show they true colors. Don't know who to trust. Mine was orders from my mama till I'm dust. God gon' deal the karma, lost my trust in every man. No, many men got me in a jam.
I'm going back to that feelings on the production other.
Before you blow it in the sky, tiptoeing over mortar and a brick, bumping shoulders with the devil in disguise. Shoulder level water on the rise, twist 40s in the morning in the winter. I heard you got your sauce at the Enterprise. Evidently it was rented, but it's mine. You was wildin', every day was trash. Crackers piling in to rake the land. Early morning, with much of everything in hand. Except the difference is, now I control it. I be in the crib and in the moment stuck, sipping out the flask. Feet up on the dash, I hit the spot of raps. Quicksand, scrambling out of that. Go behind the back, switch hand, affairs high. Niggas know they out of whack. Sterilize and click, pair neck, motherfucker. Lot of blood to let, peace to make, fuck a check. Lot of blood to let, peace to make, give a fuck about a check. Lot of maybe.
That was an odd one, I'm going to be honest. The beat was very odd to me, almost too odd for me. The vocals, again, I had my issue where the only thing I was hearing was that, it was like super, super loud. Like in the vocals just, or the lyrics or whatever they were rapping about, I felt like I couldn't even hear it because the beat was so overpowering. Yeah. I guess that's a creative decision by Earl, but personally, it's keeping me from, or it's not allowing me to fully engage in what he's saying. And maybe that's not the point. Maybe he wants you to just focus on the beat and the lyrics are just there. But I don't know. I feel like that one, I just couldn't really get into all that much. Again, it was like a relaxed feeling. I feel like I'm on the couch just hanging out with some friends, maybe like just chilling, or maybe we're just shooting the shit talking and this is just on in the background. But that one, I couldn't really get down with. But yeah, let's go to the next one. The Benz. Here we go.
Ben, we don't break. We not the bank. We all we got. Switch whips, we locate way out of state. Bada bing, bada bam, Mr. Puppet Master. All of the strings in my hand. Niggas came a long way from the dickies and dirty jam sports. Jack all trades, dealing niggas a handful. Ben, we don't break, we not the bank. Got memory chains, not a checks that we see in his hands. Some real Mike Willie shit. We bring gorilla, they really gave up the ransom. You silly resort, got torn up in the past once. Before John Young, God get the cash run. Hard hung heads might starve in the end. Young, God get it, we not the bank. Switch whips, relocate all the way out of state to my queen's keep. Mates keep faith, brother man, they stable full of shit.
All right. Again, another odd sample. Seems like Earl likes to do the out-of-the-box production, which something I'm picking up on. But sounds like, from what I gathered, the song as a whole is about his progress in life, and you can kind of understand that with, like, if you think about the song titled The Bends, like maybe like the bends in the road, like the road of life that he's been traveling. It says, bend, we don't break, we not the bank. Well, I don't think the bank line really has anything to do with it. Like, bend, we don't break, like saying, we may have gone through troubles and hardships, but we're still here. We're still pushing. The line that really kind of brought it all together for me was, my dudes came a long way from Dickies and Dirty Jansport. Jack of all trades was dealing a handful. Got memories of your face, the photo still on the mantle. So maybe you lost somebody along the way. But he's just like literally reflecting right there on that line where he says, came a long way from Dickies and Dirty Jansport, saying they can afford nicer clothes and better bags for their things now. Like, they've really came a long way in their life. Yeah, The Benz, pretty solid track. Not sure if I would add that to a playlist, but I can appreciate the song and in the context of the album. Going to the next one, Lucy. Here we go.
Main line, underneath the skin of the grapevine. Save time, serpent, no need to hiss. Confess, keep fallacies off your lips. See casualties in the wind. Now we crumbling leaf over tree pre-twist.
I bet
your heart skip a beat when you see me next. We stretch to be we hard to get involved. In the blistering cold, watching harder they come, harder they fall. I figured niggas was bold. They proved me wrong too.
Just,
I feel like I was just like taken aback, and it was so short. It was 59 seconds. I need to read the Genius description because I feel like I couldn't get past the, like I was trying to just understand what he was doing with the beat. And then before I knew it, the song was over. So reading the Genius about Earl targets a certain individual and recounts their quick and dour separation. In addition to his hatred and disenfranchisement for this individual, Earl also feels a sense of disappointment and abandonment. This song is single-handled almost completely by Earl Sweatshirt, having written, produced, and engineered the track. So that's just like, I feel like a glimpse into Earl's mind of how he thinks and maybe how like his internal song is, like where if like just how he feels, like how he moves about life. Like I feel like everybody has like that internal feeling or whatever for music inside of them. So maybe that's Earl's. So yeah, Lucy, Odd. May need more listens. Yeah, the next one, Azucar. Here we go.
Pedal to the metal,
lost foot, and it was sugar in my gas tank. My cushion was a bosom on bad days. It's not a black woman I can't thank. Call Christ, so I stopped trying. Apologize. We out of time, please get your alibi straight. You ain't got a lie, shit tradition did it my way. No sense in looking in the sky, it's in the stick on the highway. I only get better with time. That's what my mom say to die. Say to kill him this time. Boy, what happy sookie niggas wasn't shit. Face looking like I stumbled out of pit. $100 chip. I piss problems out the bottom empty. Mama say she used to see the price on my head. Less, this how we on it. If you need it and I want it, better come prepared. Hands on like a goalie with the puck. Don't need any luck. See the ghost of where I was, lonesome as I was.
Azucar, that was an odd one. Felt grand, like in just the production and the way the beat was going. I enjoyed the beat a lot in the production. Like again, like I had my gripe earlier where like his vocals weren't prominent. Vocals very prominent here, so no gripes there. The pockets I liked were only get better with time. That's what my mom said. Dodge Satan, say to kill him this time. Oy vey. Well, here I go, foot on the line. What's mine? Like that little pocket. I'm gonna read what the line thing says. It says, Sookie, Sookie, dudes wasn't shit. Face looking like I stumbled out of a pit, $100 chip. Sookie here is used to depict the poor connection both physically and mentally of him and the people he used to hang out with. Face looking like a pit, $100 chip. Pit can be used in some other context, like a mosh pit, pit of depression. $100 chip is a way of relating money, like casino chips. Yeah, I figured that. Oh, that didn't really help at all. what I just read. Azucar, cool track, short track, as a lot of them have been so far. I feel like this album as a whole is going to be multiple listens. It's short, so I'll be able to listen to it more than once. Go to the next one, Eclipse. Here we go.
Take no clips, make more tips, and work the brakes all out of my openness. Total eclipse of my shine that I've grown to miss. When holding shit in, open my lids, my eyes shut, my soul is a mist. The signs set me close, just hoping I don't total my shit. That's me though, play the game, no cheat code. Had the beach in the free throw. Your mouth running when you gotta eat. Why it's so muddy in the creek, pour three foes coming by the fleet. Keep low, peace, preach, it ain't so sunny, but nobody see me sleep. I make more money on my motherfucking feet. You take no prisoners, just make more tips and whoop. Say goodbye to my openness. Total eclipse of my shine that I've grown to miss. When holding shit in, open my lids, my eyes set, my soul is a mist. The signs set me close to the end.
Okay, kind of the same thing with the reduction. I feel like I'm beating a dead horse, and I'm sorry if you guys are getting pissed off, but it felt like the beat was overpowering. I like the beat, but I can only go so far. Like, I feel like I need the lyrics. Beating a dead horse. I'm gonna need more than one listen on this, I think. Because I'm liking the beat and I like the flow that I'm hearing. I'm just like not picking up on the lyrics because the beat is just overpowering. Might reach here and be maybe say something that I could try to connect earlier. Maybe he's trying to make a point with the production. Like, I remember earlier he was talking about his mental health and him being vulnerable. And I said something about him being vulnerable enough to share his mental health. I'm not picking up on these lyrics, but maybe he's trying to insinuate like the beat is overpowering him, like the noise, like he feels not heard. he maybe feels not heard by his friends or his family, and he feels like he can't, even if he's trying to express his emotions, like maybe he is on these songs, he just feels like the point's not getting across. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's a fucking reach. I don't know. I'm just trying to piece this thing together as a whole for myself. Yeah, let's go to the next one. Veins. Here we go.
A nigga, keep it. Peace to every crease on your brain. Peace to who came before me in the game. We giving praise and glory to your name, kid. We celebrating your story so it stays in, kid. Air Max 97 crates on the pavement. Hair got Nazi that is settled on my face. I've been eating good, you can see it in my tummy, but I'm bugging. I've been spending more money than I'm at. Thank you. Trying to stay fast and trying to get through the day. I'ma play it back, I ain't in this showing face, kid. It's been a minute since I heard applause. It's been a not a star. I can't call it dog. Sometimes I feel like I wanna call it off. I can't call it dog. Big dog, finna rip the collar off. I thinking how I'm not a star, I just can't call it dog.
Hey,
keep pace, my nigga.
Keep pace, my nigga.
Be safe, see safe, my nigga. Keep pace.
So I said something about the mental health thing in the last song, and I felt like I picked up on more of that here. So he talks about a little bit about like spending too much money, but then he oddly transitioned into saying, I've been eating good, you can see it in my tummy, spending more money than I've been making. I ain't touch a Xan. When it's time to put my body in a case, tell my mama I said thank you. So he's already talking about like dying before his parents, which is odd because obviously your parents are older than you, so saying he thinks he's gonna die soon, I guess. Then he goes on to saying like he wants to call it off, and I'm wondering if he meant like call it off like a tour, an album he's making, his career as a whole, his life, because he's just talking about how he's gonna die, and he wants like his mom's gonna see that. And then at the end it kind of just feels like a goodbye where he's saying be safe, seek sake, keep faith. Be safe, she's safe, keep pace. And then at the end he goes like, what am I doing? Just can't call it. You know what I'm saying? So I can't just end it this right here. So Veins, good track. Picked up on more mental health stuff there, but yeah, go to the next one. Playing Possum. Here we go.
To my mentors and comrades in arms, those present and those gone on, thank you to my family.
Can you see them now?
To my partner,
Westlake,
cultural worker and student of life. Whose growth and insights inspire me. A thousand kisses.
Could not carry in.
My nephews, my sisters, my friends.
Refugee.
My whole family network.
Consider.
Who have let me be distracted and inconsistent in my attempt to rest.
Consider. What staggering memories. Frightened and abort the hope that should have been. Perhaps.
Not.
I should care. And say,
you know the real deal.
Do I have a home?
That was an odd one because that was weird how it ping ponged between the ears at the end, but it was just a sample of somebody talking, reading. So maybe reading a speech or, yeah, so I'm going to read the about section. Features sample recordings of his mother speaking about him and audio of his father reading a poem, Anguish Longer Than Sorrow. The addition of both his parents was this album was supposed to be a surprise that he'd planned as a gesture, but tragedy struck again when, not sure how you say that, Kigostyle passed away on January 3rd, 2018, before Earl got a chance to send him the album. The title Playing Possum refers to the idea of fiending death, usually when faced with a situation one does not want to deal with. And in this very retrospective album here, Earl embodies the role as he chooses not to directly face the past by rapping on a track, but allow his parents to inadvertently make the plastatory gestures themselves. Earl says this about the track, the song is way less about my dad. Oh, so it's his dad, that's who died. He wanted to, okay. This is making more sense now. The song is way less about my dad dying. Why did they word it like that in the about section? Why couldn't they just, they said his full name. They could have just like said, and then quote Earl's father. Anyways, less about my dad dying than it is about a way of both my parents talking about and the conversation I was trying to have with them and with each other, just like them back and forth. It's crazy, which just like for me and people that are in my life, there's word association with that and emotion associated with that. That's just like scratches in a good itch. Okay, interesting track. Did kind of feel like a transition, so interested to see how the album finishes. Go to the next one. Peanut. Here we go.
Family slumping, now you done embrace, get the fuck back, you moving like they cut your cane, look at it, picking out his grave, can't help but fill out a place, try and catch the red pops, she sent him off and not an hour late, still in shock and out my heart out, somewhere on the range, the lock and now we elevate, we box him out, my shit a million miles away. Like we making food. Father's face, but I'm not afraid. My Uncle Hugh.
Well, kind of like an introspective one. Just before we get into it, I'm going to say the lick the nutsack line kind of made me chuckle. Besides that, though, he's saying in the track about like this depression he's feeling is not a phase. Talks about sending his father off, like probably like a funeral, I'm assuming. And death just having a sour taste. And bless my pops. He sent him off not an hour late, still in shock. And now my heart out there somewhere on the range. So I think he's saying that maybe it was a sudden death or something, or he just feels like he didn't have the chance to do everything he wanted to do with his father and connect. And just, he didn't have the chance to say a proper goodbye. I'm not sure how his father passed away, so I don't want to speak on that too much. But yeah, he's just, I think, talking about a relatable thing that everybody who has parents is going to have to go through, which is just them eventually passing away, which is tough on everybody, obviously, because they're the ones who raised you. They're the ones who made you who you are. So I haven't had to deal with that personally yet, but I can try to empathize with what Earl's going through there. And Peanut, interesting track. Go to the last one, Riot. Here we go. Riot, interesting track, was just an instrumental, but honestly felt like a coming around the corner kind of song. Like he's finally trying to persevere through this hard time. He knows that he's got to continue on with his life and he can't just let this depression maybe ruin everything that he's made possible for himself. Because early in the song, he's talking about how like him and his friends and his family have come a long way from where they started. And this kind of felt like he doesn't want to let that go. He may not be feeling the best. He may not be feeling his most self right now, but he's gonna do his best to just keep pushing forward and keep living life and know that he's gonna make it through a tough time that he's going through right now. That's what I got from it. Let me know what you guys got from it in the comments. But yeah, Riot, solid track. Even with it being an instrumental, might be one of my favorite songs off the album, actually. So with all that being said, though, let's get into ranking this album. If I had to give this album a ranking, I think I'm gonna give it a 73%. I know that might seem like a harsh score. Throughout the album, I was mentioning this, wasn't the biggest fan of his choice to making the production louder than what he was saying in a lot of the tracks. Maybe that was, like I said, a creative decision where he's talking about like this mental health thing. And if it was, it works really well. And then the album as a whole makes sense. But I also think, like, how many times do I listen to an album fully all the way through? And this one just didn't fully grab my attention and think where like I could go back and just fully listen to this over and over and over again. I will listen to it more times to see if it clicks, because one time through, it's hard to tell what if you like it off one time through. So we'll get more listens. Maybe it'll grow on me. Maybe it won't. But 73%, that's what I'm going with right now. So yeah. Yeah, with all that being said, though, thank you guys for listening to this album with me. If you'd like to see the full uncut, uncensored version, that will be linked down below in my Patreon, along with all my other socials. If you feel free to check me out there. Please, if you can, like the video, subscribe to the channel. Helps out a lot. And yeah, with all that being said, thank you guys for watching and listening with me. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Stay safe out there, guys.